book I chose as my educational leadership book for the book review is Drive, The Surprising Truth About What Motivates Us by Daniel Pink. It's a book I've read just recently this past year, and it's something that I've really used a lot as a teacher, as a coach, and I think it really applies to administration as well. Obviously deals with the idea of motivation and how to motivate others, and I think it has some good information for anyone that's looking to be a teacher or an administrator someday. Really, the summary behind it is that the motivational techniques of the past no longer work. The idea of either promising a reward or threatening punishment just doesn't work for people of today's generation and society today. Based on what the research shows for Daniel Pink, he's decided that there's actually a much better way to motivate others than just threatening with punishments or promising rewards. That builds compliance, but it doesn't necessarily build motivation, and it doesn't lead to the best results possible. Instead, he says to focus on three things, and the first one is autonomy. Really, the idea is that people should be given the choice over the task, time, technique, and team. Task being giving people some choices as far as what they do. Let them have some options. Let them be involved in the decision-making process as far as what they're going to be active in doing. Time, a big part of that is when they do it. Sometimes that's functional, sometimes it's not, but the idea is that maybe they don't always have to work at a certain time and do things at a certain time, and that maybe some people are more productive in the early morning or late at night. And if there are tasks where they can do them at their own leisure, that might be a better way to get them to get the best finished product. Technique is all about how you do it. Let them have some choice over the way that they accomplish the task that they need to accomplish. So just giving them some options there. And then team. Everybody knows the value of getting to choose who you work with. And sometimes you work well with people and sometimes you don't. Sometimes as a leader, you need to assign roles and assign partners or assign groups. But other times, I think there's definitely an idea where you could give some choice and let some people choose who they work best with. Especially when you look in a leadership position, something like an administrator, you're working with professionals. I think it would be reasonable to expect that your professional teachers could occasionally choose who they work with to accomplish their goals. So the first key to motivating others is giving them some autonomy and giving them some freedom. Secondly is the focus on mastery. Basically, it's that innate desire that we all have to continue to improve. Pink describes mastery as a mindset, a pain, and an asymptote. The idea of mastery as a mindset comes from Carol Dweck. She's done a lot of psychological research in the idea of the growth mindset. And really what's key is that if you're going to be motivated, you have to understand that you're capable of improving and you're capable of working towards mastery. And so getting your followers to believe in that idea that they are not fixed where they are at and they can actually continue to improve is pretty critical to reaching mastery and preaching mastery as a motivational tool. The other idea that's important to be honest with your followers about is mastery is a pain. It's not something that's easily accomplished. It's going to take work and it's going to take time. And I think you need to be upfront and honest when you're describing the idea of mastery that it definitely takes work. And finally, it's an asymptote. As a math teacher, I can relate to this. I gave you a visual to see this idea, but basically mastery is something that truthfully you never accomplish. It's something you always are approaching, but never truly reaching. You can always improve. You can always do better. As a teacher, as a coach, and as an administrator even, I can really see the value of preaching that idea that we can always improve. The way Daniel Pink describes it in his book is the goal is to provide your followers with Goldilocks tasks, the idea being they're not too easy, they're not too hard, they're just right. The third way that we're going to provide motivation to others is to give them a purpose. People have a natural desire to focus on things besides themselves, to take on a cause that matters to them. And so it's important as leaders that we communicate the purpose and the vision of the organization. And you see this a lot in leadership books throughout history, the idea of that vision, and the leader provides the vision for the organization. And I think this means that you're not only focusing on, you know, the nuts and bolts vision, but you're also looking at the bigger picture. You know, the way he describes it is focusing on maximizing purpose, not just maximizing profit. And then just using purpose-driven work. You know, thinking even just something as simple as always talking about we and us instead of I and you, but collaborating together and choose things to focus on a higher standard and a higher purpose, and then whenever possible to let your employees or let your followers have some say in what their purpose is. Let them choose what matters most to them. Kind of goes back to the idea of autonomy. But those are the three things that he says really would help motivate others, and it's something that I've used and seen quite a bit in my own experience after reading the book. I picked three standards that I thought this book really addresses. The first three standards of the ISLLC standards, really the main idea in standard one, you know, you're an educational leader who promotes the success of all students. And how are you going to do that? The other idea is the vision of learning that is shared. It goes back to what we just talked about with the purpose, but sharing that vision out as a leader is critical. And I think this book helps in that way. As far as standard two, promoting the success of all students by really working on the school culture, by making student learning and staff learning a priority. And I think in order to do that, you got to motivate them. You have to motivate your students and you have to motivate your staff. And then finally, I think this is a little bit of a management situation where if you're going to keep things organized, if you're going to keep things operating smoothly and effectively, you're going to have to motivate those around you to buy in. Everyone from teachers to students to custodial workers, the more you can motivate them to be excited about their job, the better performance you'll get. So that really tells you why I chose it, why I think it's a must-read for educational leaders. Whether you look at it as a classroom teacher, as a principal, as a superintendent, I use it a lot as a coach as well, but you have to be able to motivate others. You have to find ways to get them to buy in. And I think it's definitely something that's impacted the way that I teach, the way that I coach, and I really see it as influencing the way that I will work as a principal someday. If you want more information, there's a really cool YouTube video out there that does an RSA animate that kind of summarizes the book. But it really is, it's an interesting philosophy. Daniel Pink is also a great guy to follow on Twitter. Just gives a lot of good information. I really recommend the book and I recommend the author. Thanks.